Yes, I'm not an official in the Palang Basharat party, but I'm working for the government. I think the latest counting is almost 94%, and the majority of the voters voted for Palang Basharat, all 7,600,000 compared to Puer Thai, 7,200,000. But that is one count. The second count is, of course, the number of the seats in the lower house of 500. It seems like now the Puer Thai has an edge, maybe above 100, 110, 115 seats in the lower house. Palang Pacharat maybe follow that. But then again, who will form the government depends on how do you look at it. In the old system, not the mixed proportional electoral system, the priority is given to the numbers of the seats in the parliament. But now you have the popular vote, so to say. Palang Pacharat is now gaining more on that front. So it's up to the different political parties to support either Palang Pacharat or Puer Thai in the next few days.
But at this stage, is it simply too complicated and too early to say whether your party or whether any of your rivals have got a majority in the lower house? And does that imply that you will inevitably have to go into talks with coalition partners?
Of course. It seems quite likely that the next government will be a coalition party between one big party and maybe two important medium-sized parties. That is, of course, including Democrat Party, the oldest in Thailand, and Phum Chai Thai Party, the emerging new party, and the last and most surprising party, young generation party, the Future Forward Party. So you are looking at the main four players.
Khun Panitan, let me ask you a very direct question. Which of those parties would you prefer to work with? Who would you accept as coalition partners, and have you been talking to them?
Well, I think the officers in the Palang Pacharat and Puer Thai are now talking. They admitted late last night that they are now talking to all parties. But it seems like only one or two parties will make a coalition completed. On one side, you know, the pro Puer Thai, I think the new forwarded party. On the other side, Democrat Party, leaving Phum Chai Thai swinging. So it seems like quite likely that Phum Chai Thai will be a decisive force. Either camp, you know, if they move into that.
Do you have any indication which way? Because I've heard about the decisive factor that Phum Chai Thai represents. Do you have any indication which way they are going to go? Are they going to be aligned with your party, Palang Pracharath, or with the anti-junta parties?
Well, people are hopeful that no matter what they choose, people can accept that. By accepting the majority of the votes, you know, Palang Pacharat, I think if they move that way, it will be more smoother transition. But then again, this is parliamentary system. The final analysis is whoever gains the majority of the seats will form the government. So Phum Chai Thai will be very hard at work today and the next few days to make sure that they coordinate and communicate it with all supporters.
These coalition talks are going to be tricky. They're going to take time. Are we looking at the prospect of a hung parliament in Thailand?
I don't think so, because I think it's quite likely that Phum Chai Thai, before the election took place, they're in communication with Palang Pacharat already. They're traditionally very close, you know, to the many elements from Palang Pacharat,
yes,
which also moved away from Puer Thai in the last election.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.